Not all of the 12,000 reenactors at the Reading Farm are spending the day portraying soldiers. There are also nurses, chaplains, and merchants. We also met one man who believes it's his job to document the battle. His work is simple, yet very powerful. Here's News 8's Ann Shannon.
Yeah, we record history, and we saw what was going on at that time.
Perry Revlett has a unique perspective when it comes to the 150th commemoration of the Battle of Gettysburg.
I'm representing the correspondents, the artists that was back in that time, because if it wasn't for them on the field, the New York Times, the Boston, the Baltimore, all these people would not know what was going on at that time.
Revlett gets into the midst of the battle, taking pencil and paper and recording history.
From my vantage point, like I said, here's the artillery, so you got to make sure you get the sketches in there.
He draws the outlines first, then fills in the rest. The Floridian has been planning this trip for 4 months, but has dreamed about it his whole life.
Back when I was in high school, by 40-some years, I always wanted to come for the reenactment, which I do reenactments in Florida, but here in Gettysburg, you know, it's a once-in-a-lifetime.
Revlett works quickly.
And all of a sudden, you got your picture showing the battle, what's going on.
He hopes his work, like that of those who went before him, will stand the test of time.
This is history. This is live history right here in front of us.
In Gettysburg, Ann Shannon, News 8.